Hey guys, Colton with Backcountry eBikes here just to do a little bit of education on the differences between a couple of e-bikes and then explain a little bit about our bikes as well. So basically what we have today that we're going over a little bit is the Mule 1000, sort of what sets us apart to our competitors, I know, between Rambo, Quiet Cat, Rad Bikes, is basically the components that we have on our bikes. We've upgraded our motors from the normal BBSHD motor, and we switched up to an Ultra Bafang mid-drive motor. Comes with torque sensor, speed sensor, and cadence sensor, giving you more power, longer lasting battery life, and getting you farther out on the mountain. Several different components on the bikes have changed, from spokes to tire size to tube tires, from the actual tire itself, making it more rubbery so it grips the ground better as you're moving, a wider handlebar stance, locked in handlebars, hydraulic brakes, larger pedals to be able to really grab your boot when you are out in that rough, rugged terrain so you're not sliding off at any point. Our batteries are completely upgradable, all the exact same size, so it's not like you're adding, you know, another 10, 15 pounds when you're switching up your batteries. We're gaining right now at our 14.5 amp hour battery anywhere from 25 to 35 miles, depending on how much you're using that throttle. You can upgrade to the 17.5 or even to the 20.5 amp hour battery, which will get you, depending on how much you're pedaling and throttling, but anywhere from 70 to 90 miles on a single charge. We have tons of accessories, anywhere from headlights to solar panels, pannier bags that can switch into a backpack, to our awesome trailers. They have an amazing power for pulling out game, pulling in your tree stand, decoys, feed, whatever you're trying to do. A lighting sensor as well, so depending on the day, it'll brighten or contrast a little bit. Hit our information here, tons of different settings in the display system. Whether you're trying to make it a class 2 to a class 3 bike, you can change the speed limit on it so it has a governor on it. So right now this one's set for 28 miles an hour. I can jack it up and we can put it about 35, 36. It's usually what we recommend for a class 3 bike. If you want to do password, sensitivity, locks, whatever you want to do, it's completely up to you. Every bike comes equipped with a pannier rack. It's going to come with a rear fender, a front fender, and a headlight. I mentioned that we have several upgrades, so one of the upgrades that we have is this front headlight. They get pretty bright. 9600 lumen. We have a 9-speed Alveo system. So something that's cool about us as well, you know, they are mountain bikes. They're not completely prone, but if you were to have any problems, you know, bust something off, instead of having to send the bike all the way back to Utah where we are, any bike shop would be able to fix this for you, and it's not going to be too expensive to fix it. As I mentioned before, pedals real wide for a good stance, really strong pegs to be able to grip your foot really well. Batteries are right here. They have a key that just plugs in on this side. You can see right here. Plugs in right here. Little handle. You'd have to grab the key from the back, but they pop right out. Super easy to be able to change out. You can charge them, so I'll chain my bike up to a tree up on the mountain. Cool. I'll take my battery home, I'll charge it, and I'll bring it back out to where I'm hunting.
Oh.
Yeah, it changes that a lot.
Wow.
Super nice.
Cool.
Super nice. We've got a hydraulic brake system on the front and in the back. Tons of different options for bags.
There's a shock in the seat?
No. A little shock here in the seat, just giving you a 2-inch
little coverage, travel there.
So,
what's the travel on the shock?
So we've got air shocks up here on the front. They're RSTs. You can switch the PSI around on them. You can lock them, unlock them, you know, gauging for whatever weight you are of a rider. So. Here on the back, a couple of accessories. Systems will come as a dual pannier rack. You can see the little connectors we have right here. They'll connect just right here under this pannier rack system. Super simple. You can see they just slide right on. Let's catch them right here. Just clips on like so. They're waterproof. They have a welded seam, so water can't get into the seams or anything like that. We do gator grip bow rack system or rifle rack system. Just pop it right open, drop your bow or your rifle in right there. It prevents it from moving around. We haven't had any problems.
How wide does that get?
Sights or anything.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
It'll pop wide open. And then these backpack pieces are freaking awesome. you just set them right here in your backpack, in your bag, so it's the pannier bag right now, but then when you're out hiking, you know, you're bringing your feet or whatever you're wanting to do out on the mountainside, you take your bag off, pop it off like so, pull out your backpack connector piece, and then it just connects on right here with these top pieces. Just connect all four of them, and then you have a backpack. So, super easy for a day pack, something you could use out when you're riding. So, and then just our different trailer connections. I've got three different trailers. Two of them use the exact same connection piece. One of them's a little bit different, but the one that we have on this is the folding gear trailer. So it's got different options of how you want to set it up for what kind of gear you're holding or what kind of gear you're taking out to the mountain. Super easy to connect or to take off. Just a little pulley system like this. Pull that out, trailer comes off. You can use it as a hand cart. A lot of guys will have deer on it and push it out like this. Or you can just connect it to the back. We pull out, I've got videos and pictures for proof of guys pulling out antelope, mule deer, whitetail, quarters for elk, grandpa's children, you name it, you know. We pull quite a bit of weight with our trailers and the bike.